the world. You know, there's a beautiful midrash that brings a story about the descent of Adam HaRishon, the descent of the neshama of Adam HaRishon down to the world. The midrash, and also mentioned as well, says that when HaKadosh Baruch Hu wanted to bring down Adam HaRishon to be the first man, the angels came to Hashem and they told Hashem, it is a big mistake to allow a man that's going to be half man, half spiritual neshama, to come down to the world, because you know that this descent of this new creation that you're putting together, which is half spiritual and half physical, is going to sin on you. So instead of doing that mistake, avoid it now before you create it. The Zohar Kadosh says, when Adam HaRishon was supposed to come down to the world, HaKadosh Baruch Hu had a different neshama in mind. Hashem was not supposed to bring down the neshama of Adam HaRishon as Adam HaRishon. Because the neshama of Adam HaRishon had what you can call somewhat imperfections and a pull to fall in sin. There was one neshama that was at a higher level, a purer level than Adam HaRishon. What neshama was that? Avraham Avinu. Well, the Zohar Kadosh says that when the angels were coming to Hashem and telling Hashem, don't create man, they will never be perfect, Hashem said, no. Look at the neshama of Avraham. Avraham is the essence of Ha'adam Mushlam. And that is why in the Tehillim, a lot of the time, when the Tehillim says Ha'adam, it's actually referring to Avraham Avinu. Because Avraham Avinu was the essence of a pure man, the essence of a perfect person. And it's even said that the entire world was created and leans on the back of who? Of Avraham. Because if HaKadosh Baruch Hu didn't have Avraham in his back pocket, he would not create a man, a creation that will never be perfect. The only symbol of a man that is able to be perfect, to come to a perfection, was Avraham. So the question is, why didn't HaKadosh Baruch Hu put Avraham in the first body, the first person's body? Why did he wait for Avraham 20 generations later, only then to put Avraham? Put him in Adam HaRishon. So the Zohar Kadosh says that the only reason why HaKadosh Baruch Hu put Adam HaRishon as the first neshama, then Avraham 20 generations later, was because of a trait the neshama of Avraham had that no other neshama had. What was that trait? It was the tools to repair even the sin that would be done by the first man. Meaning that in the neshama of Avraham, there was such hidden tools and hidden powers that it was able to repair even the worst of sin, which would be the first sin. Meaning that if Avraham Avinu was to be the first man, and he was to fall with the sin of the snake, HaKadosh Baruch Hu would have no more reason to keep the world created. Because there would have no neshama that would be able to come down and to repair the sin of the first man. So what did HaKadosh Baruch Hu do? He held Avraham Avinu for 20 generations later to wait till the world starts to clean up, and only then to send his neshama and to bring down Adam HaRishon. That if Adam HaRishon sins, HaKadosh Baruch Hu has a protection, he has a healing, he has a medicine already waiting in his pocket, which is in Neshama of Avraham. So another question about that could be asked, why is it that Avraham has such a special Neshama? Why is it Avraham was able to repair even the worst sin? Avraham was able to essentially be the beginning of us Jewish people, the beginning of all nations. Why is that? So maybe we can say about that, the reason for that, and even the reason why HaKadosh Baruch Hu put the forefathers in the order that he put them. That he put Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov, not for no reason. Maybe we can say about that the reason that Avraham had such a power, because he was able to balance two powers, to balance two sources of beracha in an even balancing. Speaking about what? Givura, din, judgment, strength, and kindness, chesed. That we see that on one side, Avraham Avinu is deemed what? Ish Achesed, the man of kindness. But on the other hand, the man of kindness took his son and was ready to slaughter. So we see how HaKadosh Baruch Hu put that Avraham Avinu on one side has the son which represents Din, judgment, Yitzchak, was able almost to go and to do mamash shechita to his son, but also the man of kindness. That in order to be mushlam, in order to be perfect, a person needs to have that balance of judgment and kindness. In order to repair previous sins, in order to repair the past, and to bring down beracha, we need to be able to judge both of those, to balance both of those things. Where can we learn that? We He learned it from the two mitzvot that speak about what? About having a long life. About, well, what's a long life? A long life meaning that a person did not sin, he's pure, he's clean, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is lengthening his time. There are two mitzvot that Hashem actually tells us its reward. What are those two mitzvot? No, the reward, mamash, it says the reward. Doraita. So, kivud avayorim, respecting the parents, and the second mitzvah is the shiloh hakin, sending of the dove when there's eggs. We know the mitzvah. If we look at both those mitzvot, we see that they both polar opposite act. One is a complete kindness, kivud orim, that you have to have a lot of patience and kindness, and another one is what? Complete judgment. You see a nest, a baby mother, you come, you kick her away, you take her eggs, you kill the chicks. Complete judgment. But Hashem chose both of those two mitzvot to mention what the reward is. What is the reward? Long life. You want to have long life, you need to have that balance of judgment and kindness. Once you are able to have that balance of judgment and kindness, you will be able, Be'ezrat Hashem, to purify yourself and receive a long life. So today, Rabotai is a gevura. The judgment. In order to bring bracha for the week, yesterday was chesed. So yesterday we collected all the merit. Now it's to take all that merit and to put it into action with the strength. So we all, Rabotai, get up, go do chesed, but also know that you have the strength to succeed with that. All what we do today, Amen. Yom Tov Mevorach, Rabotai.